We have, you know, an ambition to solve global challenges using our unique technology, because Mars is for quitters. We're probably not a well-known name around a lot of tables at the moment, but in 5 to 10 years' time, we should be. We'll be the best technology for resolving decarbonisation issues in lime and cement, iron and steel, aluminium, and these big industries and their decarbonisation problems. Everything that's made around us comes through processes that involve heating things up. And that's the opportunity for the companies, have its technology usable in all of those different areas to assist with the decarbonisation and to make a more sustainable planet. The original idea around Calix actually came from an old mining engineer who thought of the original concept, which is a new type of kiln or furnace, a new way to heat stuff up. And that particular chap got together with our current chief scientist, Mark Sceats, and together they worked on the nucleus of that idea.
From the beginning, we had the idea of CO2 mitigation. That really was on day one. But with the issues of climate change coming forward, it was increasingly clear that everything the company would do in the end would be related to that.
Governments, industrials, all started to talk about net zero CO2. That started to pivot interest in the company from a water treatment business with some interesting tech stuff to actually a high potential decarbonisation technology company in pretty big sectors. From a very early stage, we were reaching out, not just locally here in Australia, but globally as well, to key players in the industry and in the research and development areas to help us develop our technology, to challenge us. Cement and lime was the sort of first cab off the rank in our decarbonisation technology development. 3 years ago, people started to notice we were working with some very big players, you know, the Heidelberg cements and the Cemexes of the world in decarbonising cement and lime. And there are numerous other applications, of course, that we're looking at as well. Iron and steel, spodumene, which is the main source of lithium in the world today, alumina, another one, all of these major industries requiring furnaces that can be renewably powered. And so it's a very interesting technology in terms of its ability to be applied to multiple different industries. Decarbonisation of industry is now the primary story around Calix. So at the heart of Calix is a core technology, a new type of kiln or furnace, a new way to heat stuff up, if you like. And what differentiates our sort of kiln or furnace from any others is that we heat what's called indirectly. We don't have flames and hot gases touching the rocks or the minerals that you're trying to heat up. We have a rather large steel tube. We heat that tube externally, and we can heat it any way you like. We can heat it with biomass, waste, traditional fossil fuels. We can heat it with electricity, so renewable electrons. So it's an industrial heat process that can ultimately be renewably energy powered. And what we heat goes in the middle of the tube. It needs to be a small particle size, a small powder, because what we do is basically drop it down the tube and it just floats gently down through the tube. But we heat that tube to over 1,000 degrees centigrade, and the red hot walls of the tube radiate heat into those particles. And it's quite unique and differentiated from the other technologies being developed today.
I like things simple. So at last, a way of making materials in the simplest way you could possibly conceive of. So that's the one big advantage of indirect heating. The other is electrification. That avoiding combustion altogether is the best way of mitigating CO2.
We've been very lucky because the mission of the company really attracts the type of people we want here. They are people who are dedicated to the future, to using their unique skills that they bring to the company to help solve global challenges. And it's the team and the people in combination with the technology that to me differentiates us. You know, the values that guide that team, the dedication that people have, the resilience, I guess, because this is not an easy journey. You are really taking something and trying to revolutionise the way we've made stuff for hundreds or if not, you know, 1,000 years or more, if you look at the way steel is made, for example. It takes a lot of dedication and resilience to change the way we do things.
The vision for the future is really to convert every combustion process now to an electric process. I think it's about, let's say, saving the planet. We just can't afford combustion anymore. So actually climate change is just another event that needs the world of innovation to move. But time is ticking.